Is tying the hair of female like a camel's hump, is it prohibited only in prayers or every time? The question posed was that for the female, is tying the hair on the head like a camel's hump, is it prohibited only in prayers or it is prohibited always? There's a hadith of a beloved Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. It's mentioned in Sahih Muslim, volume 1, hadith number 1101. Where Ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with him, when one of the Sahaba, Abdullah, when he was praying with his hair tied in knot, while he was praying, Ibn Abbas goes and unties the knot. So after he finishes the prayer, he asks, why did you do that? So Ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with him, replies that the Prophet said, a person who prays with his hair tied is praying like his hands are tied. And there's another hadith in Sahih Muslim, volume 1, hadith number 1100, in which the beloved Prophet said that when you prostrate in your salah, you prostrate on 7 parts: your face, your hands, your knees, and your feet. So based on this hadith, but natural, this hadith is specifically referring to the men, that when men pray, they should not tie their hair in knots or in braids. It is makruh. It is discouraged. But this hadith is particularly only for the men and not for the female. Because when the females pray, they pray in a hijab and the hair is covered. So it doesn't make a difference whether the hair are tied or they are open. And even the Prophet permitted that while doing ghusl, if the hair of a female is tied, she need not untie it. It's not compulsory. So based on that, for Salah, this ruling of not tying the hair is not applicable to the females. It's only applicable to the males. Now coming to your question regarding, can women tie their hair like a camel's hump on the head? There's a hadith of our beloved Prophet Sallallahu in Sahih Muslim, volume 5, hadith number 5582, in which the Prophet said that I have not seen two types of people who are inhabitants of hell. One is a person using a whip like that of the animal's tail. And the other is women, though they are clothed, they appear as naked, indicating that they may be wearing very tight-fitting clothes, or be wearing transparent clothes where you can see through, or tight fitting where the figure can be seen, or short clothes. They are clothed but yet naked, and they will tie on the head. On the head will be a camel's hump on the side. They will not enter paradise or smell the fragrance of paradise. So based on this hadith, we come to know that the Prophet mentioned in this hadith two types of dwellers of hellfire. One is those who will have a whip like that of the tail of the animal, and the other is talking about women who would be clothed yet naked, and they will have a hump on the head. And today when you see, there are in certain countries, like you go to Gulf countries, there are women in the abaya, you see that on the head you see a hump just like a camel's hump. So these are signs of those people who will not enter paradise. So a woman, in prayer, it makes no difference, it is permitted. But when she goes out, and even though she is wearing her abaya or a hijab, she should not have a hump. She should not tie her hair in such a way that it appears like a hump of a camel over her head. This is prohibited, and neither should she wear clothes which look that though she's wearing clothes, she's naked, you know, referring to clothes which are very tight fitting, or clothes which are transparent or translucent, or clothes which don't cover the body. So women generally, when they go out, they should not tie their hair in such a way that appears like a camel's hump. But in prayers, there is no restriction, it's permitted. Hope that answers the question.